No question, WWF Attitude was personified by the on-screen relationship between Stone Cold Steve Austin and Vince McMahon. It has often been said in the genre of sports entertainment that art imitates life and vice versa. In recent weeks, that has been all too true here in World Wrestling Entertainment. 2 weeks ago, Austin went on the WWE internet program Bite This and vented his frustration. But it didn't end there. This past Monday, just hours before Raw was to go on the air live, Austin walked out. Millions of fans at home and thousands in attendance at the Phillips Arena in Atlanta, Georgia, might have thought this was all part of the, quote, show. But I can assure you, it was not. Now, as we are about to find out, the Stone Cold era may be over.
Steve, lay it all on the line here. Give us the bottom line. What's your mindset and how you feeling about everything that's going on with the Raw brand?
Bottom line is everything sucks. I'm not happy with the direction Stone Cold Steve Austin's going. I ain't happy with the direction the whole company's going. I think the writing has been pretty substandard. I'll go one better than that. It's been piss poor. I guess if that pisses some people off, then that's just the way it is.
Well, again, you know,
I think it could have been a hell of a lot better creative than it's been going on. It's pretty as a matter of fact, and I ain't been happy with what I've been doing before WrestleMania or after WrestleMania as we speak presently.
Well, do you feel like there are movements, that there's progress, like things are going to change?
Who knows? Hell, I'm over here in San Antonio, Texas. They're up here in Stamford, Connecticut. And, you know, hell, I'm still happy to be a part of the World Wrestling Federation. Love my job. But the bottom line is creative could be a hell of a lot better than it is.
That's Stone Cold, who's, again, like I said, the most demanding, you know, of anyone I've ever worked with. Mm-hmm. And sometimes rightfully so. But at the same time, there's, you know, he's reduced to simply, you know, producing, I suppose, gold albums as opposed to platinum ones at the moment. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know, to take your point of view, you know, whether or not someone gets sour on the creative and then, and can he take that and turn it into you know, something better. I think he can. I think Austin does have that ability. At the same time, you know, he needs some decent material to work with, too. So it's a combination of things.
It's WWE Raw in Atlanta, Georgia.
Stone Cold Steve Austin did not show up.
Austin, for whatever reason, was hell-bent on not showing. He got on the plane and went home. He took his ball and went home, and obviously, I'm pissed off.
He was the lead performer advertised to be at that event in a major venue, and he didn't fulfill his obligations. He decided to go home, and that's wrong.
I had a phone call from JR, who's in charge of talent relations, at about 10 o'clock, 10:30 Sunday night, informing me that Austin was not terribly excited about his the creative that we had set for him on Monday.
He mentioned on Sunday that, you know, he wanted things changed or he wasn't coming to work. And I said, you know, that's not the way you handle your problems. It's not the way you do business. It's not the way we do business. And so I asked him if he'd talk to Vince. And he said no. And I said, well, how come? And, you know, he just there was just a lot of aversion there. He just was very uncomfortable about talking to the owner of the company about his issues. He has never been in the past until the last few months.
I then immediately called Austin on the cell phone and told him no matter what hour, you know, it was when he got this message to call me. So about 2 o'clock in the morning, he called me. So that began my Monday. I went through the entire creative process with him, explain how this was good for him and good for the company, and he said, all right. So in any event, not that I needed his approval, but it's always important when you're working with talent for them to buy into what it is you're trying to do, because they feel a lot better about it. They feel a part of the creative process, and that was what I attempted to do and thought I had done.
When I got to the Phillips Arena in Atlanta on Monday, I was informed that through our travel service that he had independently made a call and booked himself and his wife flights home.
He tried to do this in a way that no one would even know that he wasn't going to be at the event.
at that point, I started calling him again and left several messages and finally got through to him, and I think he was boarding the plane because I heard the flight attendants talking with him and how you doing, and I heard him sitting in a seat. And so, you know, we had a very frank conversation. He made a mistake. He screwed up, and he had no business going home. I did most of the talking in that conversation. The other conversations he and I have had over these issues the last 2 or 3 weeks, he's done most of the talking. And I'd listened long enough.
He had done this once before, and both myself and JR and others had the conversation. You can't ever walk off the job like this. That's the only unpardonable sin, perhaps, that there is in our business, because fans are expecting to see you. And when you don't show, it's the worst thing that can happen. So we had the history of this happening the day after WrestleMania. I just chalked up the fact that he was burned out. That's what he said. I had to take him, for face value.
It's not the Stone Cold that I know. And it hurts, because he made a big mistake. No, he didn't admit he made a mistake. I said it to him more than once. I told him to get his ass off the airplane and come to work. Face the man eye to eye, go into a closed room. I would be there if I was asked or needed or was wanted, and would help expedite a conversation to settle his issues. And then at the end of that conversation, if we were not able to come to a mutual understanding and clear the air, then he should get his ass home and stay home. He made the biggest mistake of his professional career.
From a personal standpoint and a business standpoint, I look in the mirror firstly when things like this happen and say, what could I have done, you know, to have changed it? What could I have done, you know, to not to have this happen? And I don't know that answer. I'll accept whatever blame that I can put on myself in terms of lack of communication or whatever. But when someone won't speak to you, when someone won't come to work and discuss intelligently, you know, how to get out of something, my hands are tied then. And heretofore, in whatever disagreement he and I ever had, we always sat down and always worked it out. And we always saw each other's point of view. And it always worked that way. But when someone won't sit down with you, they refuse to show up, they've screwed you.
Being Senior Vice President of Talent Relations and being Stone Cold's friend was, theoretically, a conflict of interest. That's my fault. You know, Vince talked about looking in the mirror. You know, I got a problem looking in the mirror. I'm the guy that's responsible for talent. Me. If you can't solve a problem, you eliminate it. Stone Cold eliminated himself from the issue without giving us a chance to solve his problem. He took himself out of the game. Vince McMahon didn't. JR didn't. Jim Ross didn't. Steve Williams took Stone Cold and put him in San Antonio. And so I'm going to take a lot of responsibility for this deal. And there's going to be a lot of things written. You know, half the crap you read's wrong. You know, didn't want to do this, didn't want to do that. You know, people with this active imaginations that are trying to stir crap. The bottom line is he's got some issues that maybe someday will be revealed. Maybe that someday will really be explored by the public. Because that's what the public wants. That's why I'm doing this interview now. They want to know. And quite frankly, this company wouldn't be here today or where it is today without our fans. And on that night, there were kids in Stone Cold shirts. There were people there that had posters. Those fans have made him a very, very wealthy man.
You know, when you have an investment like we made in Stone Cold Steve Austin, it was a tremendous investment. Hours and hours of hard work, you know, on his part as well as ours. I don't know, you can't calculate, really, you know, the loss of this investment for the long term. 10 years from now, Austin would not have been in the ring. But 10 years from now, Stone Cold Steve Austin, as a part of World Wrestling Entertainment, would have been making speeches, personal appearances, and things of that nature. He would always be Stone Cold Steve Austin. And so the investment that we've made is just, he just took it and flushed it down the toilet.
This is a very unique business. I think that maybe sometimes the things that go on behind the scenes are more intriguing and more thought-provoking than what we broadcast. I don't know what his problems are. I don't know why that someone that could be the biggest name in the history of sports entertainment say, I'm not going to come to work. I'm going to turn my back on the people that have helped me because I'm pissed off, because I'm unhappy, because I just can't take it anymore. And I'm not big on psychologists and getting on the couch time, and I got to have a sabbatical, and I got to have quiet time, and all that bullshit. A man's a man, and he's always been a man's man. He was the first man in the building. He was the last man to leave. And why all of a sudden we can't be trusted? And the people that have spent hours and hours with him on a lot of tough situations, let me tell you, a lot of tough personal situations, we're not trustworthy now. I'm going to go home. And I'm very disappointed. I'm damn sure disappointed. He's been in my home many, many times. I've been in his home many times. I was the only person this company invited to his wedding. I felt that to be a very big privilege. I felt honored to be there and would do it again. But, you know, we got to reevaluate where we are as human beings, as Jim Ross and Steve Williams, not good old JR with a black hat, which I'm not wearing today because I'm not good old JR, and Steve Williams, my friend, that's been affected. And I'd like to see it someday put back to where it was. But I don't know, in God's name, how that's going to happen, because I don't know when I'm going to see him. I don't know when he's going to want to communicate. And I don't know what's wrong with him. I don't know how you could just turn your back and go home. I couldn't do it. I wouldn't do it. I don't care how bad things are. We've all done things here that we're uncomfortable doing. I've had pig poured all over me in a pig pen. I've kissed Mr. McMahon's ass. I've been beat up by a woman. I've had a lot of things happen here. But it's because we're trying to entertain people, because it was a thing that we all believed was a thing to do on that program, and we did it because it was a team effort. You win here as a team and you lose here as a team. But you don't just turn your back and say, I'm not going to do this. I'm going home. So maybe someday the real story is going to come out as to why he made this decision. Only he knows. I don't know.
I'm personally hurt. Steve was a friend of mine. I have no idea what could possibly motivate him just to walk off the job like a child and take his ball and go home. Yeah, I'm angry about it. At the same time, from a professional level, I always feel that, you know, that I have failed when something like this happens. Because I always thought that I went the extra mile for Stone Cold, you know, more than anyone perhaps I've ever worked with. I always thought that I'd been over backwards for him. And this hurts, but he did what he did, knowing the consequences. And this is not a publicity stunt. This is, you know, something that unfortunately is sad, and that's what we're confronted with. This is sad, and just walking off, he spits in the face of everyone who ever supported him, spits in the face of everyone in this organization who helped him become the talent that he is. It's sad. Whenever there's hardship, whenever something occurs in life you don't expect, those who are the survivors try to take something negative and turn it into something positive. That's what we've always done here in World Wrestling Entertainment, where there's an opportunity like there is now. Austin was a huge superstar. As such, he meant so much to our company, yet without him here, notwithstanding the devastating effect on our company, it makes room for other stars now to go to the top.
It's time now for the players to play. We're going to find out who are going to be main event level stars. I believe we have a lot of potentially great ones. And we have some established stars that need to get back at the top of their game too. But it's going to create opportunity. And I think that the benefactors of it will be our fans, because they're going to see new situations, new rivalries, new stars given opportunities to live their dream just exactly like Stone Cold Steve Austin lived his dream in this company. I think the WWE is going to be just fine. I hope Steve Williams is going to be just fine.
The door is not open for him to return, and I'll tell you why. Because, again, I have a responsibility to our stockholders, a responsibility to our fans, and I, too, have to look in the mirror. And when someone walks out on you without even telling you, as he did the day after WrestleMania, and I chalk that up to burnout, And then all of a sudden, they do it again. And especially when I talked to that person that same day, that the morning of that same day, and they intentionally walk out with not informing you or anybody else in the organization that they're not going to be there, then as a businessman, how could I trust that person to come back and build him up again? And then what, just so he can walk out for the third time? So I never say never in this business, but I don't know how I could do business with him.
I just don't know how everybody could trust him, because what's going to happen the next bump in the road? You know, you're going to go home again? And I think that goes for anybody on our roster. If you don't want to be a part of the team and take this company to the promised land, you should take your ass home. Don't waste anybody's time. Pack your bag and go. But be professional enough to do it the right way. I got kicked in the guts. I was sick all day Monday. I was physically ill. You're damn right. Hell, to me, it was John Wayne. He never retreated. He broke his damn neck and fought back to come back and be the top guy here. That's guts, conviction, belief in what he does for a living. He's gone through a horrendous divorce, injuries, personal problems in that regard, and came back and pulled the wagon. Then all of a sudden, the wagon got too heavy in his mind's eye, and he went home. It'd be like John Wayne becoming a coward in a big fight. He never saw it happen. He'd never see it coming. And I didn't see this coming. And it hurt me. So, you know, most people probably won't give a damn about that, because I'll be back on TV Monday night kicking ass because I love my job, with or without Stone Cold. Would it be better if he was there? Yes. Stone Cold ain't going to be on Raw Monday night. Stone Cold ain't going to be on Raw again, as far as I know.